On February 1st, the public will get a chance to weigh in on plans to expand the Portland Jetport. Last week, the Portland City Council unanimously voted in support of the expansion plan. The $75 million proposal would double the number of security screening lanes and add three new gates to house even more airlines. But not everyone is happy about the Jetport expansion. Here now to tell us more about that, Randy Billings, a reporter with the Forecaster newspaper. So, Randy, we're talking about a neighborhood in South Portland. First of all, where is it? Explain.
Brick Hill neighborhood. It's out on the west end. It's just off exit 3 on Interstate 295.
Okay, so that was the old Main Youth Center. They rehabbed that several years ago. And why is it that neighborhood? We've heard reports before. I live up on the west end, for example. People complained about the planes then and there. And, you know, why this particular neighborhood?
Because the Jetport also needs to expand the crosswind runway. FAA is requiring them to extend it by 1,100 feet and add runway safety zones. And that will actually shift the air traffic 600 feet closer to Brick Hill. So the planes will be landing and taking off a little closer to those neighbors. And the District 5 counselor is, you know, fighting for those neighbors. They were trying to block that because they have had historic problems with the sound out there, especially with the interstate. They just got that sound wall, and now they're concerned that this runway expansion will, you know, only add more noise problems.
And we're looking at this animation here. This is the big deal. I mean, this is gates and all kinds of stuff.
Absolutely.
So this is going to be quite a project, and hopefully we'll hear more about it. And again, you can pick up the Forecaster anywhere. It's everywhere, I know. And we also want to thank you for coming in again.
No problem.
We hope to see you again next week. For more on this story, you can pick up a copy of the Forecaster again. Some of the other headlines to check out in this edition: concerns from Peaks Island residents about the response time of emergency workers, and plans to bring back Captain Newick's restaurant in South Portland. I drove by and I saw a sign of the new Captain Newick's that's coming. We'll have more of that in the Forecaster newspaper. Check it out.